I vote because I have a voice. And to me, giving up that voice is a travesty.
I know people get upset when they feel like you're being coercive to tell them you should vote because somebody died for you, but that means something to me. That somebody who didn't know me, who didn't think, so many of those people didn't think they would get the vote in their lifetime, but they thought it was important enough to put their bodies and their lives on the line for the eventuality of getting the vote.
You know, it's one time we all have the same power when you vote. It doesn't matter if you're rich or poor. One person, one vote. And it's a privilege. And everyone should know it's a privilege, but it's being part of the system and showing your influence, whatever you think.
I became a citizen last fall, and I will be voting for the first time for president this year, even though I've been in this country for over 20 years and many of those undocumented. So I think about the suffragists who fought for us to have the right to vote, the heroes from the civil rights movement that were really founders of our democracy and that made our country better. And I also think about the people in our communities that don't have the right to vote, whether it's because of their immigration status or because they are incarcerated.
The way you have to change things is, number one, you have to start registering people to vote, and then you have to get them out to vote, and then you have to, you know, bring the issues to the candidates and eventually to the people that get elected, and that's the way you make the changes. And then when we ask people to get out there and to vote, each one of us, we all have obligations and responsibilities to our fellow citizens.
Why I vote is because that is the expression of my involvement and my commitment and my transaction as a citizen of this country, of having a stake in who represents me and the issues I care about.
Well, I vote because it is a privilege and a responsibility, and because I have seen what happens when people can't vote, in terms of what happened during World War II and after. And I have seen how people in other countries who have not been able to vote and go and stand in the rain or the blazing sun or whatever to have the opportunity to vote. And we kind of take it for granted. I think it is a very important time to make sure that our voting system works, and that we will be able to have what is the pride of this country, which is a free and fair election.
The Flint story is also very much a story of democracy. We were under emergency management where we had these unelected emergency managers who reported to the governor, and there was no role really of our locally elected officials. So we firsthand witnessed what happens when you lose democracy. For me, it's personal. I'm an adopted American citizen. It is a privilege. I wake up every single day lucky and blessed to be in this country and to have a role in my community.
A vote gives me a voice in what happens in this country. El voto es la cosa más importante del mundo ahora.
Hey, thanks for watching. If you like this video, check out these other videos from USA Today to stay up to date with all the latest news.